Hi, I'm Lou Ann Hunt, and welcome to the April edition of Lynchburg 360. Spring is finally here, and so is baseball season. And here in Lynchburg, that means the Hillcats are back in town. In order to make coming out to City Stadium an even better experience for the fans, the Hillcats spent the offseason making a lot of changes to their mascot, the field, the parking lot, and best of all, ticket prices. Here's General Manager Ronnie Roberts with all the details.
If you look around, you can see all the new stuff that's going on. We had a new field put in back in the fall. That's looking good now. The mild winter helped. Made the field look a lot nicer, and new grass. New parking lot has been finished up now. Going to have about 300 additional spots, more than we used to. Fans have always complained about a lack of parking on weekends and big nights like July 4th and Breast Cancer Awareness Night, those nights. So, and they're dressing it up. The city's doing a really good job with landscaping, with islands and trees, and new lighting in the parking lot. So it's going to look really good, the parking lot. And then behind me, you can see some new poles. We're going to have our netting that's going to extend from the end of each dugout, the far end of each dugout. It'll reach up to as high as the skybox level and above. So most of the fans sitting in the stadium, other than the sections on the end, will be behind the net. That's something we've talked about doing for several years for safety. And I guess over the last two or three years, we've thought about it more and more. Had some fans get some injuries, facial injuries, and it's just we thought it was the right thing to do. It's going to be a new net. It's going to be thinner. It's going to be it's not going to be nearly as obstructive as some folks think it's going to be. And now folks who want to come to the game and sit outside, not under the roof on a Sunday afternoon, but they got young kids, they used to be wary of that. So now they can bring their family and sit outside, no roof over them, but be protected by the net. And the net's not going to obstruct that view. And we've lowered our ticket prices this year. Last year, general admission was $9, and this year it's $6 across the board. We lowered our reserve seating from $11 to $9. So we think that's a positive thing for the fans. They can come out and enjoy the evening for it. It won't cost them as much. Our souvenir store, the Caddy Shack, has been turned into a meeting room or a draft house, a draft room. We've got some special De Beers in there that groups can rent it out pre-game, or on days that the team's not at home, we can use that as a luncheon or a meeting room. So those are real positive things that have taken place around the stadium. Yeah, the new mascot, the new colors, new logo. It's been, as time has gone by since the unveiling and the discussion first started, lots more people have come to like it, like we knew they would. Some folks just don't like change, no matter what you do, and we understand that. But the new owners never intended to change the name, unless the fans wanted to change the name. So they just wanted to find out at the time, back in the fall, how passionate the folks and the fans in Lynchburg were about the name Hillcats. We knew, and I knew especially, being here so long, that Hillcats was going to be the most popular name by far. But they just wanted to find that out and feel that passion, and they did. So well, several names were offered, including the Hillcats, and Hillcats was selected and voted on and overwhelmingly was the winner. And then the colors, you know, the brighter colors, and the mascot's a little bit more friendly looking and cartoon looking. The kids have liked him. We've been in schools for our reading program about 15 or 16 different times, and he's been well received. We're still going to bring out the old southpaw. He's not totally retired. We'll bring him out for special occasions.
Okay.
And so I don't know if we're going to announce when he's going to come out or not, but folks still like the old southpaw. But new progressive look is good for us, and people have learned to like it, and we're looking forward to having more and more people come see it. new uniforms, four new uniforms, and new caps and T-shirts and all the memorabilia and souvenirs. We got that for sale, and we sold a lot of new Hillcats memorabilia and souvenirs over the off season. Yeah. So it's been nothing but a positive change in the Elmore Sports Group and the new management that came in, and along with myself, we've seen that it's a new enthusiasm amongst the fans and our staff. And we've hired some new staff members, some of our young people who are very creative, and social media has been really big in the off season. Mm-hmm. Some of these young kids are amazing in what they could do with all the social media. And I can hardly go anywhere in town without somebody saying they saw something on Facebook or our webpage. And we are going to be dog friendly this year. Mm-hmm. I think we're the only minor league park in the country that will be dog friendly every day. We've always had a couple bark in the park days where fans could bring the dogs out on a particular day. But we're going to do it. They're welcome every game. There will be a $2 admission price, and they'll have to sign a waiver, mm-hmm. and they'll be confined to Section 1 and Section 4. One of the sections is in the bleachers, and then Section 4 will be under the roof, so they can have their choice of being outside or under the roof. Okay. And we don't know how many folks are going to bring the dogs. We don't know if it's going to be 10 or 100 or 1,000. We just don't know. Right. But everything's looking up very, very positive. And in 2 weeks, we'll be cranking up here, and looking forward to it. The days of opening your gates and hoping 3,000 people to come in just to watch a baseball game, those days are probably long gone. We still have, and every team in the country has their hardcore baseball fans, and they would come if you didn't have a fireworks show or a giveaway or anything special about the atmosphere. Those folks would still come. And the major leagues experience, they experience that too. And NASCAR, all the major sporting events now know that you've got to provide more than just the event itself. But we need those fans who come out 4 or 5 times a year. We hope now they can start coming out maybe 8 to 10 times a year, and increase our attendance. But we try to provide that atmosphere. We look at it as we put on 70 different entertainment shows. Ball game is part of that. Yeah. The rest of it is the new fun zone. I forgot to mention kids zone here with 3 new inflatables. Okay. It's safe. We keep it clean. Friendly. We want folks to come and just have a good time and enjoy a ball game. So it's a lot more going on than just a baseball game. We try to make every day, we try to make the experience great every day, but there are different things happening each day. We've got some new on-field entertainment, between innings entertainment that fans are going to like. We're going to have some special events that we haven't had in the past, and we'll be announcing those pretty soon. Good. So we're just really excited about the upcoming season.
Lynchburg is a rapidly growing city of more than 78,000 people, and many of them come from all corners of the world. To celebrate our cultural diversity, Riverfront Park will host the second annual International Festival on May 6th. From crafts to music to food, there's going to be a little something for everyone to enjoy.
Hello, namaste, hola, bonjour. Welcome to the second annual International Festival 2017, Lynchburg, Virginia. I am Gulshan Eri, one of the members of the planning committee here for the International Festival 2017. International Festival is an annual celebration of Central Virginia's ethnic cultural diversity. We gather here at one place to celebrate our nations, our culture, and to share with everybody in the community the rich cultural heritage that we carry from our nations to the place where we live. This is all happening here at Lynchburg, in our own city, in our own place. This event provides a unique opportunity to travel around the world in just a few steps. At every corner, there is a presenter, an exhibitor, a vendor, and definitely someone who wants to share their rich cultural heritage with you. So be there as I was there last year representing my country as an exhibit called Namaste India. This year, we are commencing the international festival with the Parade of Nations. We've got an overwhelming response from the community members to be a part of the Parade of Nations because you get to hold your national flag and walk around the downtown area of Lynchburg representing your country. This year, we have a new inclusion. We have a kids' corner. Yes, this is for the little ones who want to have a great time yet experiencing the different cultures of the world. We would have a photo booth, a little face painting, and much more to explore from. Let's talk about food. The food is exciting. There'll be numerous food stalls to experience and taste the food from the cuisines from all around the world. You don't want to miss this opportunity, so you gotta be here. The main stage provides non-stop entertainment that is based on art, culture, and dances from the different countries of the world. So there will always be something happening on the stage, and you don't want to miss it. Last year, International Festival was an effort to bring in people and see how people want to come out and share their rich cultural heritage with all of us. We got an overwhelming response. 500 to 600 people attended the program and they appreciated our effort for the same. This year, we are raising the bar. We have a lot to offer, not only in terms of performances or the exhibitors, but the vendors, the food, the overall atmosphere of the festival is going to be amazing. It is going to broaden your horizons and give you an experience of lifetime. So for all this, we don't have to go anywhere. Everything is happening here in our own city, Lynchburg. You all are invited to attend the International Festival on May 6th at the Riverfront Park starting 11 a.m. to 4 p.m.
For nearly 800 weeks in a row, veterans and other military supporters have gathered here at Monument Terrace to show support for our troops still serving overseas. They're also the group behind a new effort to honor perhaps Lynchburg's most famous war hero, Desmond T. Doss, the man who saved 75 lives in one day during World War II, all without even carrying a gun.
You know, when you talk about war heroes, I mean, everyone who serves certainly deserves our respect.
Yeah.
But when you talk about war heroes, it's hard to imagine anyone having done more than Desmond Doss.
Yep. You know, you get the Medal of Honor for doing one thing, you know, for heroic action. He did like 75 plus some things, you know.
Yeah. Tell me a little bit more about him and what made him so special.
Well, first of all, he was not a conscious objector. He just didn't want to serve carrying a rifle. He wanted to be a medic and patch people up and save them. And unfortunately, that was the only category the Army had to put him in a box. So he was a conscious objector. So just being a humble man like he is, very thin, very small built, and put up with everything he had to go through just to go through the Army boot camp and the training. and then not get the respect from his fellow soldiers until he was in combat. And then they realized that he was courageous and as anybody that ever that served in uniform. And today, of course, Hacksaw Ridge movie brought it out, but you know, I watched a documentary years ago about him, and it's just amazing that what he did, just time and time and time again, hours and hours dragging wounded soldiers over the cliff, and then lower them down on the, on that special rope knot he had to make them land safely at the bottom. I think it was like 75 feet or so. And bottom line was, he was a courageous hero from Lynchburg, Virginia. And once you realize, hey, that's right here in Lynchburg, Virginia, we should recognize him. So way back in 2007, we dedicated the Desmond Doss Bypass. But then when the movie was coming out this year, and Veterans Day down here on the ceremony, I said, let's start a campaign to raise some money to have a historical marker, first of all, not knowing we're going to do something here. So what we did, was talking with Doug Harvey and some other members, we figured that the historical markers only put so much words on it. And we figured that we needed to let people know, show them with President Truman, get the Medal of Honor, his citation, and also the cliff that is on there. So we figured, well, let's try to put on monument terrace, a World War II memorial. But yet, you got to go through the couple of stages, the for approval, the historical committee, and then the city council. And we all got it approved, and we had the layout and design, and we have a perfect spot for it right here. But anybody walking down these steps, they're going to see here, you got 180-something soldiers and Marines and airmen and sailors killed. And they're going to look and see that one soldier to get the Medal of Honor. And I'm sure all these names right here would be honored to have him be here to say, hey, we fought the good fight and we didn't make it back, but he did. And he got the recognition that they all should have got.
Right. And it's just not just this marker. You also want to do an historical marker near his birth site.
Yep, over there on Campbell Avenue. There's a pull-off right across the street from Fairview Baptist Church. And then we're going to put a historical sign there. And then there'll be a short understanding where he was born, raised right there before he joined the Army.
What do you hope to accomplish with all this?
Recognition. Make people aware. That's what history is. If you don't make people aware, they forget. And that's why this monument terrace is right here, to make to honor and remember. And so far, I think Lynchburg has been very supportive, the city council and the citizens. We had a fundraiser. We got tremendous support from the citizens and veterans organizations that helped out with it. So it was a done deal. The city of Lynchburg didn't have to pay 1 cent.
And basically, it's easy causes to support, I imagine.
Yep. Oh, yeah. You get a good cause, a good reason, people will join. And
what do you think the movie Hacksaw Ridge has done to sort of elevate Desmond's profile?
Tremendous, because people never heard of Desmond Doss, even in Lynchburg, Virginia. And now the movie out, millions of people have heard about Desmond Doss from Lynchburg, Virginia. It's not just, you know, other places that Lynchburg's famous for, but now we've got a hero that served World War II that's real famous. Not like, well, I think it's Audie Murphy type folks, you know, everybody heard of Audie Murphy. But now people are going to watch the movie, watch the DVD, whatever it is, and they're going to say, Lynchburg, Virginia, Desmond Doss. You know, he's saved 75-plus people.
Well, or a good association to have, I guess, with the town of city of Lynchburg.
It is, and we're just honored to put it here and recognize him.
That's it for this edition of Lynchburg 360. Show your love for Lynchburg this month by joining us for the city spring cleanup on April 22nd from 9 a.m. to noon. Just show up here at Public Works and we'll put you to work. And while you're out there keeping Lynchburg beautiful, don't forget to take some time and enjoy the view.